has been around for millions of years. It's a universal language that constantly grows and evolves, and today it comes in many forms, from the original series that you stream on Netflix to your next favorite song to the work you see on DeviantArt. Cultures have their own form of art. Maybe it's their music, their dances, or as told in today's anime, their stories. In winter 2016, Studio Dean said, "Hey, let's try and share our culture. Let's make an anime about storytelling and narration, and let's share it with the anime world, showing a new part of Japan to many. Oh, and while we're at it, let's make it really sad, pull at the heartstrings of many, and make them cry horrible and ugly tears. Will this anime work? Maybe? Hopefully? Kind of? Maybe not as much in the West, but hopefully it will do better in Japan. Thank God it still fills them up here on my channel, because it gives me a good excuse to finally review the winter 2016 anime, Shouwa Genroku Rakugo Shinjuu. By the way, this week is worse than the last, so now you're really gonna want to prepare your tissues and get some ice cream while you're at it, because you're going to need it." Former Yakuza member Yotaro is fresh out of prison and has one goal in mind. Rather than return to a life of crime, he has discovered an old traditional Japanese art called Rakugo. Rakugo is a form of comedic storytelling where a single person gets on stage and has to tell a story, acting out as the narrator and all the characters. He must sit on his knees and not stand up or move his legs other than to make small gestures like shuffling in order to advance the story. Finally, the storyteller is given one prop, which is a fan, and he must find different uses for it. Yotaro had the privilege of experiencing a Rakugo performance in prison from a famous Rakugo master named Yakuma Yurakute, and now he wants to learn the art of Rakugo from the master. At first he fails, but Yakuma is so amused by Yotaro that he takes him in as his first and only apprentice. After moving in with Yakuma, Yotaro meets Konatsu, a rather cold woman who was taken in and raised by Yakuma after her father's untimely death. After settling in, Yotaro begins his training as the next Rakugo master. But as much as the first episode would like for you to believe, this is not Yatoro's story, but his master, Yakumo. The story follows Yakumo as he enters the world of Rakugo and tries to become a Rakugo master. At first, I was surprised that the story took this route. I was expecting to see more of Yatoro and his girlfriend's trials to becoming a Rakugo master, but seeing Yakumo was much better. He's the one who gets pushed and challenged, as at first he never loved Rakugo, but when he comes to love it, he still fails at it. He is beaten down by his failures and his rival, and is brought back up as the Rakugo master that we see in episode 1. And seeing his growth as a character and watching his story was not only interesting and enjoyable, but absolutely captivating. Yakumo's character also gives a good commentary on how the artistic struggle is real, and in order to become better at your craft and get noticed by doing it, you're going to have to keep working at it and find your own style and your own voice. Yakumo must also overcome his greatest rival, his best friend since childhood, Sakeroku. Sakeroku is miles better at Rakugo than Yakumo. He's fun, full of energy, and love of his craft. He has a vision and a goal that he's determined to meet, and as much as he annoys Yakumo with his wild ways and constant need for money so he can go drinking, Yakumo will admit that he loves having the guy around. Sakeroku is also Yakumo's determination. He's his driving force. He wants to pass him in the world of Rakugo, but he also wants him to succeed and become a master, possibly even better than him. It's a real love-hate relationship Yakumo has with this guy. My only major complaints that I have with the story and the characters are more of small nitpicks. First, while the story is very episodic, there's also these small unexplained time skips, leaving me to wonder how much time has passed since the last major event that happened. Second is how Yotaro is passed to the side, and we never see him again until the final episode. When I first saw him, I fell in love with him, and even called him the best character of Winter 2016. Because just like Sakeroku, he's full of love, passion, and energy for his art form, and I would love to see more of that come from him. It would be a bigger complaint, but with the promise of a second season coming as told by Yotaro himself, I can only hope we get to see more of him in the future. Behold, this is a Studio Dean anime. I know it sounds scary and hard to believe, but this is a good anime with good animation. The character designs are great and pleasant to look at. The animation is above Dean's usual quality of animation. The colors are more traditional and kind of rustic, giving off an old but welcoming feeling to the show. It also allows for an easy change in tone when needed. My praise for the animation, however, goes to the directing and visual storytelling during the Rakugo segments. Remember 5 seconds earlier when I said the colors allow for an easy shift in tone when needed? This is what I was talking about. The animators allow us to join the storyteller while he's performing. We are allowed to enter his mind, see what he sees, join his world and his stories, and at times we're able to join the audience and view and feel their energy. It's those moments where we join the storyteller that makes my jaw drop. The soundtrack I unfortunately was not able to listen to, as this is a new anime, and you're probably not listening to it in this video besides the opening. But if I had to take a wild guess, the soundtrack mostly consists of jazz with a mix of traditional Japanese stage music. I can gush about how much I love this opening until you had to duct tape my mouth shut. The music paired with the vocals and the excellent animation is excellent, and a song I can listen to all day. Ending theme, on the other hand, is a much more mellow jazz track with an instrument that I'm not really fond of, and that is the trumpet. So this is one of those rare cases where the trumpet is put to good use, and I once again fall in love with it, as the ending theme is very soft and is supposed to calm you down after all the character drama you went through that episode. The animation is nothing but still images, but the reason why you don't skip the ending is because of the song. You can if you want to, but it's kind of hard as soon as it starts. Finally, my praises go to the Japanese voice cast, because when you have an anime dealing with a subject like Rakugo, you're going to need some damn good voice actors with a lot of range, and these guys delivered. The Rakugo moments were acted out flawlessly, and the range of the actors is a big contribution. If this anime ever gets licensed and dubbed, then I hope they get good voice actors with a good amount of range. Pray with me now that it's Funimation and they get Eric Bell and Michael Solasad. It breaks my heart to see how underrated Rakugo is. This was my favorite anime last season. Every episode had me captivated, and I even waited for it to finish airing just so I can binge the rest of the series, and I was not disappointed in the slightest. The story and learning a new form of art was interesting. The character interactions were enjoyable. The character drama was well written. The animation was excellent, and the music is very well done from what I've heard from it. And now for the feels part of today's review. The character drama only pulls at your heartstrings ever so lightly, but it's the ending that makes you cry ugly, awful, horrible tears. I am serious about that tissue in the ice cream, people. It will help a lot. And so I present Shouwa Genroku Rakugo Shinjuu with a near-perfect 4.5 out of 5 stars. I will give it a perfect 5, but I have to get less hype about this anime and think about it more. At the time of this video, Rakugo is unfortunately unlicensed, but you can stream it right now over on Crunchyroll. And when you're done with Rakugo, I recommend Nana, which is about two girls named Nana. One is a hopeless romantic who doesn't really know what to do with her life and easily depends on other people, while the other is a much more independent punk rocker who wants to meet her goals. The second recommendation is a blind one, but I've heard nothing but good things about it, and that is Kids on the Slope, which is apparently about a bunch of misfit kids who find common ground through jazz music. And that is all for me, everyone. Please tell me what you think about this anime. Love it? Hate it? Plan to watch it? Let me know down in the comments below, along with an anime you would like to see me review next. Please remember to drop a sub, leave a like, and until next week, we close off this month of feels with one of the saddest anime I have ever seen in my life. Next week, we review